I guess happy Thursday. It's the big mug this week. I needed an extra dose, so sometimes you just gotta call in the big guns. But I hope you're having a good week. Okay, do you know this is my office? I'm not gonna joke about how it's a corner office, but it's my office. But one thing I like about it is the view I get. I get everything from the far side of the parking lot all the way, not only the entrance, but around past the pond. And what I love about here is that you'll see a lot of nature. Birds, the geese, when they show up, I'll see deer as they go through. Every once in a while, a pack of dogs will go through or whatever. But one of the most interesting things that happened one time is I watched a bird land out here. And then all of a sudden, like three or four smaller versions of the same bird landed around it. It was obvious what was happening. The bigger bird had gotten there first. All the other birds had followed it. And they were flapping their wings and they were opening their mouths. And I thought to myself, here's a mom who's wanting to get away from her kids just for a moment, and they're still following her around wanting to be fed. And I thought, first of all, I thought, poor mom, she can't get away. She just needs a break. I mean, she has spent her entire time with her offspring taking care of them, probably just needed something to eat for herself, and then they all follow her down there. And then my second thought was, those birds can fly. They can get their own food. And so I have this moment with this mama bird and these baby birds outside of my window. One is just noticing this thing happening in nature, which I'm sure it happens all the time. But the second thing was God began revealing some wisdom to me through that incident. And that was, when we overly take care of people, sometimes we create a dependency that we didn't intend to or need to. We call that enabling. The other thing is, sometimes we have to stop being baby birds, and we have to feed ourselves. I'm going to let that one sit. But doing what I do, being on a church staff and speaking and preaching like I do, I'm always looking for insight like that and wisdom that's all around me that I can, like, do something with. That's where our illustrations come from. That's where analogies that I try to draw in and the things that I'm doing come from. It's just kind of being observant to everything that's going on around me and then trying to pull something from it. It reminds me of a verse that you've heard me use before, because I just think it's a much overwhelmed and unappreciated, overlooked and unappreciated verse. And it's Romans 1:20, and it says, God has placed himself in all of the world so that we should be able to find him, and we don't have any excuse when we don't find him. And sometimes we're going through the world so mindlessly and without thinking that we don't notice things like a mama bird whose baby birds are able to take care of themselves. And so when I look at everything around me, not only in nature and in creation, but in relationships, the way the world works, I realize that the world is loaded up with opportunities to grow and to mature and to find truths in nature, whether they're Christian or not, or labeled Christian or not, that I can find truth that I can apply. Paul found this when he went to Mars Hill and he was preaching, and he noticed that there was a statue that said, to the unknown God. And then he read the saying, in him I move and have my breath and being. He wasn't quoting God or Jesus. It was a pagan saying to a pagan God that Paul was going, see that thing that you feel? See that thing that you're experiencing? Let me show you how God is in it. And so he didn't, like, thrust upon them this truth or understanding of God. He said, this thing that you already feel, this thing that you're experiencing, that you're not sure that you have the words for, let me give you some words for it. And so people knew this wisdom, but they just hadn't connected it to God. All of that to say, this Sunday, in our third Sunday of a fresh start, it's 2023, we want to begin again a new year. You know, maybe some things about 2022 were hard, rough, we didn't know what to do with, and we want a reboot, we want a redo, we want to start over. And so we're looking at different things, different ways, different practices that we can incorporate in our life to help us go into 2023 with a fresh start. So we looked at our foundational relationship with God, we looked at examining and testing to find a genuine faith, and now we're going to talk about wisdom. Now, I love wisdom. I've got books in my bookshelf on wisdom. I love little tidbits of knowledge of wisdom because basically it's other people's experiences. There's his mom with his baby birds that I can look at and go, oh, there's some truths in that that I can apply to my life. And according to Scripture, it's all around me if I look for it. So that's what we're going to talk about this Sunday. I'm not going to drop content like here's some wisdom, get it on you, but ways that we can design our life, the way we can fashion the way we go through our daily routine to learn from everything that we see around us, that everything can be a lesson, everything can be truth, everything can be some kind of little piece of understanding that can help us in our own life. So that will be this Sunday. We hope that you join us. A couple of announcements to bring to your attention. We are still redoing our building use policy. We're getting so many requests for people to use our facilities because we've just got really nice facilities here. So we're still working on that. But if you have anyone that you know that's interested in using facilities, contact our office and we'll see what we can work out. Stephen is rebooting the student ministry for the start of the year. They will meet this Sunday. They will release and worship the same time the children release, and they will go to the student room. And we're hoping to really grow that over this upcoming year. Our food pantry is this Sunday. All of the signs are already around. We are working on a shuttle system because we're having some people now who will park their car in the food line, then they'll come in and join us for worship. We're so excited about that. And so we're working on a shuttle system to get you from your car to the front door for worship and then back out to your car. And then those of you who join us online, we have three streams. I hop it back and forth between all the streams on Facebook, YouTube, and now the app. I noticed that we had people on all three of those streams Sunday morning. I see you. We're glad that you join us. You can jump in the after party link after worship, and we've had people that have just kind of jumped on and hung out with us for hour and 15 minutes after worship. So we enjoy that. I've got to get into the day. I've got some stuff to do. Watch yourself with the storms today. Why is it with Thursday? I don't understand Thursday and storms. But anyways, be careful. So, hope to see you Sunday, and take care.